Hello, hello guys, and welcome back to Astronaut. In this episode, we are trying to get through Corruption 12. Last time, we did not do so good. We only got to Act 2, last boss in Act 2, and that didn't really work out. And, well, to be honest with you guys, I'm struggling. I've been trying to, actually two times in a row now, and that haven't happened before, but I have to be honest here. I was recording, and I tried a couple of things here, and two times in a row, I didn't get past Act 1. Corruption 12 is, well, it's a combination of me making two big mistakes in both of these two runs that I tried, and also the combination of heroes that I choose with the RNG. I was really unlucky with the RNG, like really crazy unlucky. But it was also the combination of heroes didn't work out for me. So I'm just gonna go and say, I just don't care about these levels anymore. I don't wanna take the warlock because he's not working for me. I don't wanna take the cleric because he's not working for me. I don't really wanna take anything that is not working for me. I'm gonna take things that's working because otherwise I won't get anywhere. So I'm gonna take the blood mage because he's working for me. I'm gonna take the druid because he's pretty damn good, and that's two healers. And then I'm gonna take the ranger. Or am I? Because that's not a lot of damage. I think I need some damage here. I think we got actually two front units pretty much here. At least I probably use the druid more often than not as the front unit, but just because of his frail. But we need some damage instead. Who's gonna work, and who's gonna work very often? I don't mind the Frostmancer actually. But I'm a little. There's more than one. I mean, I want the assassin, but I don't want him yet. Who's gonna do some decent damage for me here? Who's just a decent damage dealer? I like the Pyromancer. He's doing pretty good. Same with the Wild Mage. He's not bad at all, but both of them need some very specific items. But I guess that's the case for pretty much everyone. Except from the assassin, he just needs some speed, and he's good. you can have some crazy builds with him, but just give him three speed items, upgrade them a little bit, and he's doing 3k. No problem. So he's quite good. We had the alchemist last time. I'm gonna go with the Frostmancer. He's not really hardcore damage, but. The frost alone will actually make us get quite far. His frost is really, really strong. Especially now after the 1.3.3 update. All heroes increase their max health. That's not a bad shout at all. Blood Mage definitely like that. Defense. Yeah, maybe. Attack? Not really. Reduce the cost of their abilities. Now that's also very interesting. But I think I'm gonna go with hell. Okay, so hopefully I could get past Act 1 this time, because I was really in a dilemma where I was, do I really want to upload this episode that I just made before this? Not the one that you watched, but the one that I was trying to make, where I just lost two times in Act 1 and I was getting really salty. Trust me, the RNG was really bad. And yeah, I just didn't want to upload it because it was just bad content. So I decided to just say, fuck it, delete it, get into a new one, and just see if you can power through this and choose some characters that actually is going to work for you. And also, hopefully not get really unlucky with the RNG, because that was just, oh, moly. Some of the items I was getting for the, it was just terrible, man. Just so terrible. But hopefully it's going to be better this time around. Look at how strong this is. We're not even losing health here. Holy shit. Oh, well that's pretty helpful. that's actually not bad. Yeah, that's a no-brainer. I don't even need it on him, but the question is, who actually won the starting MP most here? Probably the druid. Yeah, probably the druid, actually. But that was pretty decent. That was a pretty decent start. That is very helpful for the Frostmancer. Yeah, should be good. Just slowing that down the enemy speed is a very, very powerful way to do this. It's just very powerful. The Bloodmage is doing fine just with no item, to be honest. Crystalline Protector, Hero Sigil, that could be good. Forgotten Idol. Yeah, you know what, I'm gonna go with the Hero Sigil here. It's not really, this was not a really obvious choice, but I do like this item. It's very helpful. In many situations, at least. How much? Just 132 absorb for everyone here. That's pretty decent to begin with. This early on in the game, that shield is very, very helpful. Not that we really need it because we got so much healing, but... yeah, easy battle. Good. I like the combination... ooh. See, that's a good item. Oh, you're kidding me. I don't think we need it, but are you kidding me? Ah, we're taking the frozen shell. That's a pretty damn good item for him. With all the freeze we got going on. I'm inclined to take another normal battle here, to be honest. Because I think we can win it, and we need the morale and the items it's going to give us. Yeah, let's go for more normal normal battles. I actually think it's a very strong option to go for normal battles early on. If you can, but you need this kind of setup to actually go for normal battles. You can't just take anything and do normal battles and get the morale up. You actually need some characters that can do it. These three characters and the items I just got, that can do it. That can definitely do it. See, how much defense is he gonna get? It's gonna go up and down because we're using the freeze as well, but it looks pretty good. He's like 80 plus. Like 80 plus. What is he normally? 50. So yeah, that's pretty damn strong. Pretty damn strong. Why are you kidding me? This seems scripted. This is scripted, man. What is going on? Sure. Give me that. Put that on him. Okay. Another normal battle. Sure. This is going to be a little bit tough, the elite battle down here, because that is the one that is going to pierce. Is he piercing? Or is he bleeding? I think he's piercing us, actually. No, this one up here is piercing, so it can't be... oh, that's going to be a tough battle. This one is going to be real tough. Because we got so much healing, he's going to do so much damage to us. Oh god, that's going to be tough. But I don't think we are going... are we going top or bottom here? I think I'm going bottom, because I don't want that merchant anyway, so... gonna take the bottom boss. I think it's poisons or bleeds or something he's doing. Probably poisons because it's a spider. Ooh, now this is an inventor. That battle is... I don't like this. We might lose here. Actually, I'm moving out of this adjusting the thing. I don't like this bleed. He might survive. He got so much defense. So that their attacks is gonna be... yeah, it might be okay, but I'm not sure. I mean, he got 65 right now. Let's see how much he's gonna get. 105 just from... is he dying? Yeah, he's probably gonna die. Yeah. The bleeds are just too strong. Or is it? Ooh! Wow! I did not expect him to win that. Or get through it. Whirlwind Axe. You know, I'm probably gonna take it just to have it. It's not really good for anyone here, but the Fool's Crown is gonna make the Blood Mage better, a lot better. That's a tough choice because we also do need some. I mean, the thing is, the Blood Mage is gonna make more damage with just health, but down the road we will probably have the assassin, so having a whirlwind axe in our inventory is very, very helpful. I'm actually gonna go with that. I'm probably gonna give it to the Frostman's, because he can actually use it. It's not a bad item for him. He's just very slow. He has a base slow speed, but he do get frost on with speed build. He actually do need a speed build. I think a speed build is the best on him, because just adding, especially with all of our frozen shells. So that might not be, that was probably the best choice I could do here. I had actually forgotten how he was applying frost. I haven't played that much with him. And speed build might be the best choice here. Yeah, let's move them out. Whoop, whoa. Oh, it's the speed. Yeah, he is reducing our speed. Don't care that much about the druid speed. But I do care about the poison he's putting on us. This is going to be a tough battle, I think. We might lose the druid. Yeah, I think the druid is going to die. Because of the poisons. The poison is going right through that defense. Yeah. Alright. But it's alright. It's alright. I did expect that to happen, to be honest. Because we were not really up for the poison. Bandithood. Oh, you know what? I think it's the best of these three items. A bit more speed for the Frostmancer, and he's gaining hidden, and he's gaining more gold for us. That could be very, very helpful down the road. Could go for the Stone Barb, but I think the Bandithood is just a little bit better here. I'm gonna give it to him. Okay, one event. Let's see what this event is. Here we go. Gain an ability. All ball heroes lose 5 attack permanently. I don't really care too much about attack on these guys. Lose 12 morale. Hell no. But I do want the ability all. So, yeah. We're gonna take the hit. 80 frail defense is way powerful. Way, way powerful here. Compared to the... Yeah, I mean, that's also pretty good, but not as good. This one is pretty good. But I think I'm gonna go frail defense. A normal battle, and then a couple of events, I guess. Okay. Okay. Do have a couple of pots with us as well. Ooh. We probably want to kill that guy first. Yeah. Ah, ruin. Oh, yeah, but yeah. This has gotta be one of those fights, isn't it? Yeah, just go for it, whatever. Yeah, we're gonna lose one morale here, probably. I mean, the defense is really working out here, but... Is it gonna be enough with the ruin on? Probably not. He got a lot of health, this guy. Yeah. Tough fight. Speed, more speed for the Frostmancer, not a bad shout. Also, it is applying frost and burn, so go for it. That was not a bad item, actually. Yeah, events. Health, 60 gold. I don't feel like that's worth more than an upgrade to an item, so I'm not gonna go for it. But 5 morale for 10 gold. Sure. That's the best choice of the 4 of them, so I'm gonna go with it. Look at the Blood Mage damage here. Interesting. Select an upgraded item. All heroes start with 30% less max health next combat. Sure. Well, that's interesting. That's also pretty interesting for the Blood Mage. I'm gonna go with the Fool's Crown. 200 health is gonna be equal to 300-400 more damage in a fight like the last one we had. So yeah, why not? it's usually not good. I'm very unlucky in this situation. It's usually not worth the 8 morale. Sometimes it is, but... But I still I want the RNG to be on my side here. Please, RNG. Please, come on. It, just once. God dang it. I don't like this one at all. I've never found a really good use for it. Not worth the 8 morale loss. Not at all. Okay, merchant. We only got 110 gold, so we can't even upgrade anything. Unless we're selling something. It's worth nothing to me. Not really worth it at all. Ooh, this one on the other hand could very well be worth it instead of an upgrade. I have, you know what? I don't really. There is just way too many innocent or whatever legendary items that I really don't like. There are just way too many of them. I think I'm gonna upgrade instead. That is a good shout to upgrade just to get the shield. That is also pretty damn naughty. This is also really good because that is just applying more frost and we can have 10 stacks of frost. That will help out these guys quite a lot. Whirlwind Axe is also a good shout because that's also applying more frost and just helping us with damage. I think I'm gonna upgrade the Whirlwind Axe. I think that's gonna increase our damage output the most. And by that, we can survive a little bit longer, I think. And also, just... I'm gonna go with that. I'm not given more reason than that. I think that's gonna be enough reason. Oh god, this fight. I'm not sure we're gonna win it. We might actually lose it. Because we got so much healing. And we are actually reduced max health. So we are probably going to lose it. Oh, the Frostmancer is going nuts now. Come on! Oh, nice. Okay, good. Oh, wow. With 30% max health lower in max health, that we still got it. That's quite good. Not the best options here. I think it's time for Bloodmite tanking. Maybe. I don't know. I think the Druid is still better for that, but... Yeah, with this frail? Yeah, sure he is. I'm gonna go with this one. Because applying one frost to an adjustment... Yeah, that's gonna be very, very helpful in the next act. Very helpful. And also, he is quite fast now. He's quite fast. An upgrade that's bleed uncontrollably? Hell no. All heroes have reduced healing next combat. I'm not gonna go for it because it is a boss fight and I don't want to lose a third time in Act 1. Oh no. A piercing. Oh my god. Oh my god, this is just the most horrible... Why game? The third time in a row that you're giving me the most horrible boss at the end of Act 1 for my setup. So he's doing piercing, which is terrible for the druid. Absolutely terrible. And then he's applying ruin to my target as well. That means the druid is absolutely useless as a tank here. 100% useless. Oh shit. Are you kidding me, game? That is just... I'm gonna use Blood Mage as tank here. Because you don't really depend that much on defense. But the Ruin is just... Oh, it's just killing me. And the Bleed. Wow, this is the worst possible... Again, this is the third... Now, you haven't seen the other tries. But this is the third time in a row where I'm getting the exact counter to me. The exact counter. He is the exact counter, and I I don't know how my RNG is this bad. I just don't understand it. It's just mind-boggling how in 3 times in a row I'm just getting some terrible boss fights. You haven't applied rune yet. Now he has, okay. But we are still getting healed. How? Because of his passive, I guess? Not sure how we want that. But I guess this passive is actually not a healing. But because he got healed. Somehow he got healed. I'm just not sure how. But he got definitely healed. And we had ruin on us. So there is something funky going on there. Something that I don't understand. At the start of combat and when you use your active abilities, gain a shield equal to 150. Okay. See, the Frontmancer is doing really nice here when he's allowed to do stuff. Blood Mage did really strong as well because he was taking damage. I feel like going Wild Mage here because this one, along with this one, would be a really strong choice just to have that on the Frostmancer, and that would allow the Blood Mage to stand down here and do his own things down here as a healer. And it would give the option for the Druid to, where we could, when there is something where they are piercing or stuff like that, we can just use the Frostmancer as a little bit more as a tank compared to the Druid, because the Druid will just get smushed when it's bleeds, poisons, whatever. Let's go with that one. I definitely like that one a lot more than the other choices. I would not mind taking what is called the Reaver, whatever. But I feel like taking the Wild Mage here. Yeah. That just seems like a very, very good choice. A very obvious choice, and the last hero should probably be the assassin. But that just seems very, very strong to me to do that. I don't really see enough why I wouldn't do that with the current setup we have. He's gonna be really good with that weapon. And this one, and then if we can give him like a symbiote or something like that, that would be the build. Boom, build done. Yeah, I'm good with that. I'm good with that choice. You can have that, and you can have that. And you're already pretty decent. I mean, that's a pretty good build. Yeah, sure. You know what? This one might be better on him. Double frozen shell. Who are we gonna upgrade here? Nah. I mean, yes, but yeah, I'm gonna wait with that. This one, it's not a bad choice. It's definitely not a bad choice, but I actually think I am going a Wild Mage here for active abilities. That one was also a good choice. Definitely a good choice. But I think I'm going to go with the Frail Defense, maybe? Maybe even more Frost? I feel like the Frost is really strong. But the health here is also pretty good. But he don't have that much health yet. Well, he do. What is it? It's 5% two times, so it's gonna be 50, it's gonna be 100 actually, 100 health every 2 seconds. Sure. Shield gained. Well, that seems pretty strong with the hero sigil and with the wild mage now, so I'm gonna go for it. That's terrible. That's just a so model rat. Right. I guess we're going Mother Rat and whoever this one is. I think that's the easy boss. The one I'm calling the easy boss with the scorpion tail. But it could be up here. I don't remember. No, it's the Grave Digger. This is the Grave Digger. That's actually not too bad, I don't think. He's piercing, right? Yeah. No, he's doing that thing where he is hitting our guy with the most damage. That should be good. That should be good with our... Yeah, he should be easy enough, I think. But I'm not 100% sure about it. Yeah, I think the Wild Mage will be fine here, getting the hits. I'm not actually sure about that. Let's just give him one hit from the rat and let the druid take the rest of it with his frail defense. And his frozen shells. Ooh, it hurts. Come on, kill them. Good. Okay, so far so good. Oh, hello. Well, no, we don't have the pyromancer. It's the wild mage. He don't need that. More defense? I'm inclined to take it just to apply some poisons as well from the druid. I mean, there's nothing really else I like here. I mean, the speed is decent, but I don't really need the burns. And I will take it instead of the bandit hood, probably. You know what, I'll give him a few more defense. 80 now, okay. Plus the 80 frail, so that's decent. 160 to begin with, and yeah, you know what, that's not bad at all. Okay, let's move on. Get some more rats, I guess. Yeah, okay, and the Krogalisk. Right, we're gonna kill that rat first. Oh, wow, what the hell? Please heal. Whew, that was a big hit, man. Went right through my defense. That's not too bad on him. Not too bad. But I would like to get a symbiote, please. Now we need to think. Now we need to think. I am very inclined to take the Scimitar for the Frostmancer, but not for right now, but for when we get the Assassin, when he is losing his Whirlwind Axe and his Bandit Hood and all that, then it might be really good with the Priest Scimitar. I don't really want Priest Regalia, do I? No. Don't really find a very nice use for that, but I think the Scimitar is definitely worth taking here. Just to have that option is pretty good. Okay. I'm not gonna use it yet. I don't think, at least. Or maybe I do. Here's the thing. It might even be better than the bandit hood here. Because he's at 1.7 and 65. This is 70 and 1.5. That's actually better. It's a bit... I mean, no, it's not. Because we do have the whirlwind. So it's actually not better. But It's gonna be good. It's gonna be good when we when the assassin is gonna come in, and we can just go give him something else instead of speed. I think it's gonna work out for the Frostmancer here. Just not yet. I don't think I want to give it to anyone actually. Could give it to the Blood Mage. Yeah, I think that's actually not too bad. Starting MP. I mean, the frost is really nice, but... maybe you want the starting MP instead of speed here. Yeah, you do. You do. You definitely do. Okay. Wait, hold on. Do you want that instead? Of the bandithood? I mean, the bandithood is giving us gold, so... yeah, we're gonna keep the bandithood for just a little bit longer here. I mean, this is definitely better than the bandithood, but I want gold! I want the gold. Roll one die, gain an item. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna roll one die, because I'm never getting anything good from this premium game, and it cost me 35, so... oh, that's fine. I'm okay with that, for sure. Go one up and then down to the elite. Yeah. See if this is a tough fight. That should be too bad. This should actually not be bad at all. I mean, they're doing some random damage, but... as a minor curiosity, but I don't think we're gonna be in trouble here. They are so slow. They're gonna be even slower. With all our freeze or frost or whatever. Yeah. I mean, I could do more damage with the Wild Mage if he was tanking here. But I just don't have that feeling that he's gonna be fine. I would like to get one more Protector. Then he would be fine. Oh. Oh. See, that's a very, very, very good option here. That's not bad at all. That's probably worth taking, actually. That's also good, but not as good, I don't think. Wow, look at the Blood Mage damage here. Yeah, I think I'm gonna take the Saber, because it's just... seems like a pretty good... Fuck that Bloodhood. Bandithood. Get out of here. Because that alone will up the damage for the Frostmancer. Significantly. A lot. Significantly. Okay. The mother of all rats. Right. I don't even need to read. Do we need to do anything here? I'm not sure. She's doing piercing. That's a little bit worrying, but. If anything, we're probably gonna use the Wall of Life on the Druid. But I don't think it's gonna be needed. Or maybe it is. It's gonna be a close one, isn't it? Nah, probably not. The healing is wrong. What? Oh, we didn't. It sounded like we actually lost morale, but wow, we're doing really well here. Oh, an upgraded version. Well, don't mind if I do, I guess. There we go. That should help. Yeah, it's close to me upgrading him now, but I think the... nah, I don't know. The Blood Mage is really strong with this setup. Yeah. He might even keep the Scimitar, because he's just doing crazy stuff with that. Because he's getting a high attack base. And that makes sure that the Mirror Pain here is doing 315 already now. That will only go up. That will only go up. And his healing is probably also going crazy. Yeah, it is. Interesting. Normal battle. I'm worried. Oh, it's just rats. Okay, well... Well, they're playing Ruin, but I don't know. It's probably not as bad as I think it is. I could pierce them, but I don't really want to use my pots on this. The druid is getting weaker and weaker for sure. Okay, he's dead. Fair enough. I could have used the pot. But I don't... I mean, I do have a lot of morale to just lose one here and there. Lit wraps? Nah. Increase your defense. I don't really want any of this. Yeah, I didn't really need any of that. Okay, elite battle, here we come. Gravedigger, yeah. I mean, if anything, it's probably attack speed, but we are freezing him, so... Stun? Nah. I think we win it. I'm not sure. Oh, you're hitting the Blood Mage with his ability. Well, that's a bad choice. That's a bad choice, Matt. That's a really bad choice. He did it again, I think. Or maybe the... Wow, the Frostmancer did. Well, the Frostmancer is good with this build. This Sleetstone Saber is gonna go nuts. Yeah, there's nothing here that I really want. Could go for the Chainmail on the Druid so he won't get burned. And that's actually... That might be a pretty good choice for him instead of the one, probably the safety slime. But I don't want to use it yet because it's not upgraded. Yeah, I don't know. I'm gonna upgrade the Frostmancer here, I think. Yeah, go ahead. I mean, the Lich Wrapped is pretty good on the Wild Mage. Yeah, go ahead. I don't have room for this. Just don't have room for it. Is this still better than this? I think it is. I just think this is better right now because of our build. Because we got the Frostmancer. I just think this is better than the Lich Wrap. In any other situation, I would probably go for the Wrapped, but... Here? Nah, not so much. Where do we want to go from here? Probably just for events and a merchant. Oh, yeah, sure. Pick his luck. We almost got 300 gold now. That's pretty good. Bandithood did us some good in the end, but, you know, still tough. Still tough. Oh, God. Yeah, we need to take that damage and just kill this Krogolisk up, hopefully really fast with the Wild Mage tanking. I feel like that's the right choice here, so we won't get this... really big hit on everyone, and the stun. The stun is gonna be bad for the Frostmancer and for the Blood Mage. I'm a little bit worried here. Might use the Holy Water. Oh yeah, nah, I don't want to use the Holy. Maybe I do. That was close, but we did it. Frostmancer, Blood Mage, Wild Mage. The Wild Mage is not doing too good with this build, to be honest. But he's doing a lot of healing with his absorbs. So that's good. Frostbinds are really strong here with... But I mean, speed builds are strong. The speed builds... Sure, go ahead. Why not? Why not? Yeah, why not? The path of change. Oh, yeah, let's just take the absorb. Another event, and then the merchant. We got 300 gold. That's nice. Rod of casting for 3 gold. I mean, I'm. Nah, it's not a bad item. Crystal Weaver. What is that? Oh hell no! No no no! Lose 8 morale. You know what? I can gain 2 items here and lose 8 morale. No problem. I'll do that. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe the noble ward is not too bad on. I'll actually do that. I'll actually do that. Giving him a little bit more health, and the negate is gonna be helpful, I think. Okay. That was decent. So, what are we gonna do here? This is gonna be a strong build. He just needs. Well, we didn't get. Ooh, now that. Yeah, that's an open. Yeah. I'm going that direction again. I don't care. I'm going that direction. It's just insane. That is just. I have seen it before. I know what it does. I'm just not sure if I want to. That's also pretty damn good. But is it good enough? Because this is just insane on the Wild Mage. Absolutely crazy. His ability is going nuts with this. I wish I had a symbiote. But this is also pretty damn good on him. So, I mean, it's just good. But I have a feeling I probably need to upgrade the druid a little bit. Because he's not going to be much of a tank. Soon enough. Unless I upgrade him. Yeah, let's give him some more negate, some more health, some more defense. Damn it, we already used all of our gold. Well, we can sell one thing here. Definitely sell bandit hood. Not gonna use it again. You're gone, we can upgrade again. I am... Oh man, this upgrade is just so good. It's just a naughty thing to do. It's just naughty. Naughty. So I'm probably gonna take the rogue. Oh, sorry, the assassin. Yeah, get rid of it. 96, that's not gonna be enough, is it? I think. Oh, I don't know. This one I don't really need it, but I can't really get to. I need to sell 2 items. And it's probably not worth doing that. Then I will only have 2 items for the assassin. Nah, I'll rather just wait and have the options. I mean, I could get more items here, but I don't really need to upgrade again. I feel like this is strong enough to actually kill this boss. I don't remember what this boss is. Hopefully it's not going to be a bad one again for us. I think my RNG have been bad enough for now. At least for today. Thankfully, you haven't seen the worst of it. 50% less max health next combat. for 50 gold, 75% chance to get 50. I mean, with my RNG today, I'm definitely gonna take the penalty here. Don't make a bet on this. Don't make a bet. I love it. It's just so good. It's just, it's, and even on the worst possible hero, it's just like, oh, thank you, man. What have I deserved to get this? So we got shields and we got major curses. Okay, not the worst boss in the world, but with the reduced health on him, it's just so bad. Are you kidding me, game? Oh my god. Oh, that's... Oh. I'm gonna go Blood Mage tanking here. I'm gonna go Blood Mage tanking. Ah, that worked out. Is it actually any good to do armor on him instead of nah, probably not. Yeah, we're gonna go for that. This might even be better for the future, to be honest, even. The Blood Mage is a pretty decent tank, but yeah, he doesn't really have the armor either, so it's gonna be a mix of all of them. But this is definitely better than the Druid with 400 health. Oh, that's a big heal, okay. Can you do that again? One big more? Yeah, there we go. Wow, the heals are crazy. Holy shit, the Blood Mage is crazy as a tank. At least against their bosses. Your attack supply, Ruin, Frost, Silence, Aura, Poison for 50 damage. Meh. Hmm. Avalanche. I mean, why wouldn't I do that? Because the Frostmancer is also removing it, right? No, he doesn't. He doesn't remove them. I think Avalanche is just the way to go here and give it to the assassin. Yeah, here we go. That was a really nice RNG with the Avalanche. That's a really, really strong item here. Great stuff. Great stuff. Oh dang! Okay, got flashed. Yeah, we're gonna go for the assassin, but it's gonna be in the next episode, guys. I want to do X3 in the next episode, but definitely assassin and just give him the Avalanche and actually the Whirlwind and maybe this one, and he's gonna go bananas. And the Frostmancer can still be good with the other speed items that we have and apply a lot of frost, and that's gonna work with the assassin. The Wild Mage can be off tank, do some decent damage up there. Blood Mage, sometimes tank, sometimes it's gonna be the Druid as a tank. Depending on what situation we are in and who we are up against, I think. If it's gonna be hard hitters, well, Druid is going in. If it's gonna be, you know, someone single target and... I don't know if the Blood Mage is worth tanking with, but he's definitely not a bad shout because he's also doing a lot of damage. So I guess against bosses, he's not a bad shout. But if there is more enemies, that's just going to smoothing him out. he's probably not a good tank then. But if it's just one big guy, sure, he's probably a really good tank then. So, yeah, guys, I'll see you. Finally, I got through Act 2. Yes! Hopefully we can win this Corruption 12. I really hope we can with this team. It's a good team. Everything here is... I mean, the Wild Mage. I'm inclined to pick... If we got Symbiote and another Lit Wrap that is upgraded, just put that on him instead of these two. This headdress of Fury is absolutely naughty. If he got a Symbiote, it's just going insane with his Wild Burst ability. He's just going all crazy then. He will have so much attack. So much attack. So, yeah, but we'll see if that's gonna happen in the next episode. Folks, see you around next time.